The Thai government is hoping to lift the economy through its $13.5 billion handout program. Prime Minister Pettonthan Sinawat says the government will distribute about 145 billion baht, or over $4 billion, to low-income earners and vulnerable groups starting September 25. Over 14 million people will receive payments starting next week. The government is keen to boost the underperforming economy, shackled by high household debt, weak spending, and slow export recovery.
From the figures, we found that the first vulnerable group that receives 10,000 baht has a high spending rate. And so there will certainly be a jolt to the economy in the first phase.
Over 220 people in Myanmar are dead in just over a week as Typhoon Yagi batters its central provinces with heavy rains and floods. 80 others remain missing. The United Nations also warning more than 500,000 Burmese urgently need food and water, as well as shelter and clothes. UNICEF says several flood-hit regions remain difficult to reach due to the damage to roads, telecom lines, and power networks. Yagi is the strongest storm to hit Asia this year so far, and has left a trail of devastation across parts of Southeast Asia.
Items from the iconic 90s sitcom Friends are going under the hammer this month. In celebration of the show's 30th anniversary, costumes, including sweaters worn by Jennifer Aniston and the late Matthew Perry, will be auctioned off. Also going under the hammer, the famous orange couch and the sign from the show's Central Perk coffee shop. Organizers say this early, bids are starting to come in.
We also have some studio-made reproductions, which were made just for this auction. They're pretty rare, including a full-size reproduction of the Central Perk couch, which is one of the most iconic couches in history. Everybody knows it from the show, from the theme song. So many famous scenes were shot there. So it's a ton of stuff, and any Friends collector is going to be, I think, really psyched to own one of these pieces.
Philippine authorities are validating reports reservists in the army are part of the so-called Angels of Death of jailed televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. Michael Deliso joins us on the line for the details. Michael.
Hi, Ron. The Philippine Army is working with the Philippine National Police to verify reports that some army reservists and militiamen are involved with the Angels of Death, the alleged private army of jailed pastor Apollo Quiboloy. Alleged victims of sexual abuse by Quiboloy also mentioned these so-called Angels of Death when they were threatened by the pastor if they break the code of secrecy. Colonel Reynaldo Balido Jr., the deputy chief of the Army Chief Public Affairs, said some members of Quiboloy-led Kingdom of Jesus Christ are reservists, including its media arm, Sunshine Media Network Incorporated, or SMNI, which is an affiliated unit with the Philippine Army Reservist and was accredited in 2015. Balido noted that the Philippine Army does not control the unit during peacetime, and the control over reservists only applies during wartime and national emergencies. The official also clarified that reservists are supposed to be unarmed. Should SMNI be proven involved in violations, their affiliation may be revoked and administrative charges may be filed, according to Balido. The head of the company, who also serves as the commander, will face questioning.
They are called the 2nd Signal Battalion, Philippine Army Reserve Unit, affiliated reserve unit. So, tinatanong natin sila because of their expertise in the communications na nagagamit natin. But as to their involvement, we will closely coordinate with our law enforcement agencies' counterparts.
Mapatunayan ito sila dahil sila nga ay duty bound pa rin, no? Mayroon silang dapat i-uphold na professionalism, duty, honor.
Kahit reservist.
Yes po. May mga corresponding disciplinary measures na mabibigay sa mga mapatunayan na nagkasala or may ginawang hindi akma doon sa kanilang sinumpaang to.
That is Colonel Reynaldo Balido Jr. of the Philippine Army. Back to you, Ron.
Michael Deliso with that report. Thanks.